The most difficult thing working in Australia is to define the Australian character, because it's something that every Australian has a different view on. And we were defining it not just for Australians, but for an international audience. So the big themes of the land and the culture and nature combined with migration and ultimately industry were the very broad themes that we started with, and then started narrowing down and saying it's all very well having these grand themes, but how do you illustrate it? And I think in the end the triumph was the creative directors who were responsible for each piece, that they were able theatrically to present these themes to music without words, without scripts. They didn't have to be explained with poetry or anything else, or spoken word on stage. They held up as interpretations of the Australian character and the big themes in our lives here, with music, with costume, with dance, with sets, with props. And they're all very different, and that's really due to the genius of the creative directors. It took about 2 years in development and execution. There were also a few dead ends that we'd develop something, build it, and then find that it actually didn't work, or it didn't work the way we wanted it to. A couple of themes were developed. We spent a bit of time on birds because of the flying equipment we had at the stadium. And that turned into a dead end, and we ended up with fish instead of birds. If you went to Central Casting and said, I want a very self-possessed, very brave, unflappable 13-year-old who looks a bit younger, they wouldn't have found Nikki. I mean, she just came out of the blue. She's fabulous little performer. And fearless isn't quite the right word. I'm sure she's got fears. But as a performer, she was just incredible and intrepid out there in the middle of the stadium. Never seemed to be affected by nerves. We were more nervous for her than she was. Really what made the night for me was the Indigenous moment, partly because of the way the audience reacted to it, but also the integrity of that piece. I mean, that's not showbiz, that's real people. For the opening ceremony overall, we had a total cast of 12,697 with 600 reserves. We had 650 near enough professional backstage people, everything from lighting and audio and communication, stage management, hair, makeup, plus the production coordinators and the cast coordinators and the creative teams. That was about 650. We had another 4,500 volunteers working backstage. They'd helped us build the costumes, build the props, but they were also marshalling the performers, getting them onto buses, getting them off buses, doing roll calls, feeding, watering, taken care of, you know, the whole gamut of production. And we had nearly a bit over 5,000 people backstage and 12,700 in front of the cameras. I think now that people have seen and heard it, they get a feeling for the sheer power of a very big marching band. There's something about it when you see that many people walking in sync and doing those extraordinary intricate patterns while they're playing music. It's very stirring stuff. I first saw a very big band in Los Angeles in the 84 games when we had 812 musicians, and the 2000 just was seemed like a good round number. For me, the great disappointment on the night for the Cauldron was that it worked so perfectly in rehearsal, and we'd rehearsed it to music. It was all driven by computers, and the movement of the Cauldron had all been timed to that Berlioz Te Deum piece, and it rose as the choir sang and it moved and all those things, and in rehearsal it was totally, totally awesome. So on the night when the dish quivered and stuck, David Atkins and I were standing beside each other and we both went, oh dear. And then it all went very quiet in the control room. We were talking to the guys down at the winch control area, who said they'd get back to us as soon as they could locate the fault. And it turned out to be just a switch had malfunctioned. No explanation of why, but it was sending a false reading to the computer, which shut down the sequence because it hadn't been given the okay for the next sequence. when the engineers checked it and found that in fact it was just a faulty switch, that the cradle was okay, then they overrode the program and it got moving. But it was a very long 3:40, I think it was. Most of all, I guess, the response by the audience to the work of the creative directors and the performers was really what made the night for me, knowing that it had all come together on the night the way it was meant to.